All right, welcome to a special video series of hip hinging to deadlifting, and it's my guide to teach you guys what I think you should be doing to get yourself into proper deadlifting from a hip hinge position and learning how to do that hip hinge position first up. So let's go through that first. The best way to get your hip hinging to start with is going through a bridge. So I'll briefly go through the bridge and then we'll move to hip hinging and standing. Now the reason why you do it in a bridge, this position here, is it's unloaded, okay? That's really, really good for people who have been diagnosed with a disc problem or they had it in the past, they've got a bit of back pain, maybe their core's not too good, maybe their glutes don't work. It's always important to perhaps start lying down in an unloaded back position so you can learn the mechanics first, all right? So in this position, you'll be doing a bridge, okay, because you are unloaded. Now the trick about the bridge, it's not just about pushing up and hip hinging, okay? There's a lot of mechanics going on with this. We've got to get that right for you to then go and do it in standing, all right? So to start with, what we're going to get you doing is making sure you're in neutral, all right? So I don't mean arched up. It doesn't mean flattened. It means halfway in between that nice neutral position, all right? Now, with a bridge, which is an unloaded hip hinge, you're trying to pivot at the hip joint, okay? The ball and socket hip joint, okay? Not trying to bend here, okay? So it's not a Pilates type roll into a bridge, it's a hinge from here, because that's what we've got to do in standing, because you're not going to move your back in standing when you do a deadlift, so you've got to learn the correct mechanics here. So first of all, you're going to tighten your core here. Now the way I do that is a quick breath out, like that, not pushing out, right? Just a quick breath out to keep that tummy reasonably flat but toned. And what that does is it stops my back moving. Okay, so I am tightening here to stop my back moving, and then I've got a hinge through here. Now the best way to do that is push your heels down. Okay, so I'm gonna tighten here, push my heels down through the floor, and magically my pelvis lifts. Okay, so I'm bridging. Now, when I come up, I push my heels down, I'm tight here. When I come up, I then use my buttocks to clench to activate more of my glute to get my hips extending more and more and more. I'm still putting power through my heels. There's my bridge, and I've got my buttocks fully on, my heels down. This is tight, my back is in neutral, so I'm not overloading my back. I'm not extending my back. My back does not move because I don't want my back to move when I'm doing a deadlift, right? If you do that, you're in trouble. So it is a breath out, push through the heels, clench the buttocks, and then keep it all on and lower your bum first. So if your bum hits first, it means you're not flattening your back. All right, so that's your bridge. Now, to advance your bridge, put a band around your knees, externally rotate, get some more glute activation. That's a really good tip, all right? The other way you can do it is put a band around your hips and do a banded hip extension, okay? So once you've done that bridge, you've got that sus, then you go and do a hip hinge in standing. So you're going to mimic the deadlift position,